Hey y'all, a quick video, very, very fast, because it's a busy, busy, busy weekend for me. A stack of papers to grade and a really big, fat custom order to keep working on by early next week. So, with that said, I hope everybody's having a beautiful day, wherever you are, or evening, night, wherever you are in the world. Our weather here in the lower part of the country, the mid-east part of the country, southern mid-east part of the country, has been really crazy. It's like 70 degrees. It's February. There's supposed to be rain, a warm rain tomorrow, so it's just all over the place, and my allergies are just like, ugh. Anyway, let me get right to this. This is an Easter kit, by the way. Everything Easter, Easter, Easter. Lots and lots and lots of vintage. If you're new to my channel, hello. And you'll learn very fast that my kits are very eclectic. There's really not any uniform to it in terms of, you know, modern stuff. It's kind of mixed and there's just a variety. So with that said, let me just start quickly here because I don't want this video to take forever. Where do I start? Actually, let me just start here, guys. So let me put all the ribbons over here and start with the little bits and bobs and doodads and pieces. This is a little floral piece. That came from my great aunt's estate. I still have a ton of her old flowers. That's so pretty. It seems so simple and, you know, just, I don't know. But it's got a purpose for sure. And then I started curating and I put some purple and pink ribbon in here with a little Easter magnet there. Here's some doodads here. There's some puzzle pieces. And I think I doubled up on the Easter eggs, as you'll see in this pile. There's some pearls. And there's some tinier, smaller Easter eggs. And if I turn it over, there's some pink beads in there. And some letter beads and buttons and all kinds of really cool stuff. This stuff really, and there's buttons too. I think the dangles, you know, or it could be like a mixed media Easter board. I don't know. I just put a lot of goodies in there. So there's that. And then in this bowl, I sort of doubled up on some of this stuff, which is fine. I have plenty of it, but you've got, let me sit it down here. Oh, and by the way, here's some pretty buttons. Let me just show you these quickly. Up close so you can kind of see these. So there are those. And I tried to pick, you know, colors that are pretty and Easter-y. Okay. So there are those pieces. And then in this little pile, there are these cute little embellishments that would make a cute Easter or even a spring journal embellishments. And these pieces come out of a, I think, guys, you guys know this better than I do. I'm not familiar with scrapbooking names or any of that kind of stuff. I think these are for banners. This is a cutout from a vintage book, and this is a I think that's a patchwork piece. I'm not sure. So you get those. And then there's more Easter eggs. Here's a cute, very vintage rabbit that I saved from last year. I had several of these, and this one I saved for this year. And it's hand-painted. I don't think you can see the... Wait, let me see, guys. Hang on. There she is. And you can see the little hand-painted flowers, the little florals there. She's really cute. And she's wooden through and through. Very cute. A little ornament there, and then I included some, I guess these are daisies, some trim, So there's about a yard or more of that. What else did I put in here? It's just a host of pretty little things. Here's some more ribbon here. And here's a cute little rabbit embellishment. Here's another cute little vintage ornament. And this little chick has got its mouth wide open waiting for mama to put some food in there. So cute. Love that. Sorry I'm sniffly, guys. There's a cute little ducky. My allergies are so bad. It's the mountain cedar is what's getting me. And I think I had several of those little ducky buttons. Little baby chicks. There's a little ducky eraser. Here's a little stamp. It's a Stampin' Up! Stamp, 2005, and it's of an Easter egg. So that's kind of cute. And there's some other stuff in there. There's some butterflies. That's an old butterfly earring. Broken jewelry piece. I think it goes this way. And other stuff. Okay. And then, let's see. For ribbons, I've got some vintage Grogaine blue. Some lavender. There's some yellow lace. There's some pink. And some green lace. It's really pretty. And some gingham yellow. Whoops, sorry. Rocking you around here. Some gingham yellow. And some green. With little florals. I think this is contemporary. And some orange. A very soft sort of a dreamsicle orange with some polka dots. And then there are, in addition to these pieces, there are these pieces here. This I'm almost out of, guys. This is so pretty. I've used this in several kits before. It just makes really cute like tag toppers if you cut the florals out. But it's also beautiful to put on books as well. Down the side of books, and there's a lot of it in there. I'm almost out of that. It's so pretty. I just love that orange color. So you've got that lace trim, and then there's more of that. I included this in one of the green kits recently. This seam binding here. I love this pattern, and then I just stuck a pink pin in there. And then you get in addition to this pretty pink, there's three different Easter colors there in blue, pink, and light green. Okay, and then the paper, I'm just going to fly through it because if you're new to my channel, it's like very eclectic my kits are. There's just a surprise at every page. In this kit, did I include a book? I don't think I included a gutted book, but I may include a gutted book in this as a thank you to the buyer. So usually I will include a vintage old book that's already gutted unless you want me to send it to you with the papers, with the block in the book, still intact in the book. You can just let me know that. But for this kit, there isn't one, but I may include one as a thank you. So there's some tickets in blue and yellow. So you get those. And let's see. Let me do the papers here. You've got a lot of vintage here. There's a lot in this pack. In fact, guys, there's probably, I'm positive there's enough in here to actually make two kits. All right. So let me just fly through it and I won't talk. It's all vintage for the most part. Music paper. Very vintage original ledger. More music paper in a different size. And these sheets, I included two of these because these papers are really thick. They come from an old book that had maps of California in it, and those maps sold. I just took them out and was left with these beautiful gorgeous vintage this coloring here, the patina around this page. I sold the map, so this paper is really thick, so you might make tags or banners, or you know, if you're doing mixed media, you can cut that up. It's very sturdy. And then more music paper in a different size. And these are still intact, as if they would be in the book. Another music sheet in a different size. This is that A something. I don't know what size you call that. A4, A, you know, I don't know. but it's a lot, it's a little bit more elongated, I should say. There's some matte page that's vintage. Everything is vintage unless otherwise expressed. Green pastures. Images. And then I put in a lot, too much, I think, of vintage greeting cards. These are old. And these have some really cute little bunnies in here that might be cut out and put into another context, obviously. Very cute. I think these are from the 50s. There's a little tiny envelope in yellow. And I'm going in no order. This is, I think, scrapbooking paper. Envelopes. Everybody can use those in their journals. There's some, now, these are contemporary. Little invoices. These are a little bit older. So those are fun. They make great journaling spots. My brother-in-law gave me these old guest checks. It says at the bottom 1990, but aren't they cute? They're so cute. I just love the size of them, and they make great journaling spots. And then here are some old pattern paper cutoffs. You can make tags with those, or pockets with those, or banners with those. Those are so pretty, and I love the colors. Vintage book pages. Love this one, this image. More music paper with rabbits and chickadees, little birds, very cute. This music paper says Mr. Rabbit, very darling, love that. And then I have, let's see, some money. Again, this is no order. More money. I tried to stick to all Easter colors, guys, but sometimes I stray. Bingo card. Vintage image. An old... This is one of those old Whitman cards. Those are so fun, and I had to have that one that has the little rabbit on there. I hope you can see that. Basket. Now, this is a stamp I bought for like 25 cents. And I just tested it out on this old card. These are some of the cards from the old recipes I've shown before. And I'm not going to grab it because I'll be forever. But that's the stamp. And it's busy. It's really, really busy. But I stuck that in there just for fun. And in this little envelope, I'm sending Beth Wallen some more of these little envelopes. I got them sitting over there ready to go out. I just have to do it. Just have to send them because they fit her little journals. She made the comment that these work with her journals really well. But I put in there some little tags and little tiny things. And some of you will probably likely know where this stuff comes from and what the name of the company is. I don't have a clue. And there's some tags there. This is contemporary stuff. There's an old rabbit. Isn't he cute? I love that. And here's another vintage greeting card. And that's an old one. Happy birthday for a five-year-old. Love the little rabbits playing. That would make a cute cover, too, probably. Let's see. What else do I have in here? Here's Betty. Got to have Betty in there, and she's got her bonnet on, and she's carrying a basket of florals, and there's some lamb and sheep and a goat. Very cute. And there's an old vintage card with some florals. And let's see. There's some ledger. More ledger, and that's vintage. And pinks and blue. And there's a scene of Heidi picking some flowers. There's a napkin. Writing paper from stationery. Old vintage stationery. Vintage images from children's books. This is an Eloise Wilkin drawing. And again, I mentioned her work before. She's really popular, and sometimes in my Etsy shop I just sell just the images of some of her kids because people seem to really love and respect her work. I think she was a wonderful, is perhaps a wonderful children's artist. She's really popular. She's in a lot of little golden books. There's some coin tubes in green, orange, blue. There's some scallops. There's a chicken and another little chicken. I just cut those out with my EKG die cut. There's a butterfly sticker with a flower. These are vintage. And I've had these for a little while. Happy Easter. And these are those cards. One of them signed that you'd put on flowers that you're delivering to someone. But these are, they're old. Let's see, there's a bee, some florals, and a butterfly stickers. It's a springtime archival acid linen free. And that's a cutout from Paper Adventures. A card, Monopoly, yellow money, vintage. Easter cards. This one is a bunny cake. As I say, my kids are really, really, sorry guys, my kids are really eclectic, and they do include a lot of vintage if you're interested in that kind of thing. Not everybody's into vintage, but even if you're into the modern journal embellishments and supplies, it's always kind of neat to see a pop of vintage or surprise. I like the word more surprise of vintage. It's great. It's just awesome. I like the word pop too, though. It's okay. And there's mints. There's some more of these. And here's some cute little girls. And they are, I think, dressed for Easter, probably around the early 90s, it looks like. There's a card with some eggs. That's probably contemporary. Here's another vintage little image from a sewing pattern. And then another host of old cards. that are signed. This one came from my great auntie's estate. It was given to her. And let's see, this one. Yes, this one also from my great auntie's estate. That's a Mother's Day card, but look at those little birds. Aren't they cute? Little blue birds. There's a rabbit. Some florals. Rabbits. A mixture of little cuties. There's another Heidi image. And that's from a very old book. More book images. And I'm really sorry, guys, my videos are so long, but I like to be thorough and not make assumptions. So I want to make sure you see everything. And there's just too much vintage goodness to see here. This is really cute. Love that image. And then here's some pretty images of rabbits and butterflies and spring and Easter. This is my favorite. This probably is why I didn't put a book in here, and it's the takeaway. But I may, like I said, I may add an old book in here as a thank you. This says to my sweetheart at Easter time, and it is just gorgeous. And look at this little, I think journal makers today do this kind of thing now. I think Sagita does that, and Paula Lemon does that. Valerie at Pumpkin Patch kind of plays around with this kind of thing. It's just cool. And certainly Nick, the booksmith, does this kind of thing. But I thought it was really fascinating. And again, this comes from some cards I secured years ago, just a host of them. When you see the Happy Easter, Whitey. I love you, Red, 1951. Isn't that beautiful? And then it's signed March 26, 1951 on the back. But I love this little thingy here. And that's, I don't know what that kind of material that is, but it's kind of like some of the first looks at mixed media, I would argue, but I could be wrong. I'm a seller, not a crafter. Cute bunnies, a bunny, some old blue pages, an envelope, this way. And let's see, why did I put this in here? Florals, orchids. There's some spring beauty there. Look at that bee. American bumblebee. Really cute. And then more images of rabbits. There's a butterfly. This is the flowish in me now. I always have to have something in there that is like, surprise! And flows. This is so cute. Okay. Then I have, this really gorgeous piece of material here, and it's got these beautiful edging here, or it has this beautiful edging there, and it's in a baby blue, so that's really pretty. I also have some vintage rickrack. This is unopened. It's in a very pretty blue, 100% cotton, light blue, and it's open here. So you just have to be forgiving of the scuff marks there. But you can, oops, and see how fragile that paper is. There's no barcodes on this. This is really vintage. You can save that for a sewing junk journal. And this is really old too. I didn't even take the pen out of it. I just left it as it is. It's on this very yellowed card. But it's a beautiful seam binding, a soft, very Easter yellow. And then here is a host of baby blue lace. Now, I probably will take some of this off and save it, you know, for another time. So when you get the kit, if you're interested in the kit, just be aware that this will not come like this. You will have a good yard or so of that. Let's see. There's a couple of doilies. I'm almost out of these. And lastly, because this video is going to be super long, I won't talk the usual in my kits. This is contemporary stuff. There's two paint chips in Easter colors. Those make great tags. Envelopes. Another one with green. A very long Easter color bingo card. That, I don't know what the date is on that. And then finally, you've got some paper. And my paper is not new. I get sort of the leftovers of what people don't use or what they don't want. And so you've got some Easter colors here. This is from the Vintage Workshop, the Paper Adventure, guys. And again, I'm not familiar with companies and all that. So there's an Easter piece, and you can see where there's one egg cut out of there. But I think that would be really cute. There's some gingham yellow, some pink gingham, some yellow dots and spots. And this company is Making Memories. That's foreign to me. there's some blue, I don't know what you call that, just blue stripes, blue and white stripes. And this has some embossing on it. You can probably see that a little bit. It's called pastel, flower pastel yellow, and it just has a barcode on there. So these pieces are likely not vintage. There's some cute little Easter dudes. Chicks, chickadees. There's some more eggs and chicks and chickadees. And this doesn't have, these two pieces do not have names on them. There's one of my vintage images scanned. And why did I put this in here? Not because of the raccoons, because of Hiawatha. Love this cute image here. That would be even a cute little book cover. And I may link up gosh, there's so many people. I got a lot of people to link up to my upcoming videos. Joanna Clough does a really beautiful job in using old children's images. And someone else, Amity Bloom, she does too. So very, very cool stuff. I tell you, I fall in love every single day with what journal makers and artists do, and it inspires me all the time. Lastly, you get a big hunkin', and Shannon Green's word, hunkin', and my best friend in California, she says that all the time too. Big chunk of old pattern paper. And then this is vintage. The last part. This has, what does this have? Let's look at the label here. I haven't looked at this stuff. Sometimes, guys, I don't even look at stuff until I open it on camera with you guys. This says Simplicity Transfer Pattern number 1412, made in the United States, copyright by Simplicity Pattern Company. It's a lost piece. It's a, you know, a remnant of probably what would have been an interesting pattern, but I stuck it in there because it has florals on it and some really cool designs. So there's that. And the last part of this pristine vintage kit is this. And this is another remnant of some pretty florals. I guess if I turn them the right way, it might be more effective, Renee. There we go. So that has some pretty florals. And I just sort of, really honestly, guys, you know, sometimes I go through my stuff and I'm surprised at what I have, which is why I have that big fat black Victorian lady kit just sitting up there. I'm not interested in making books. I'm not a bookmaker at all by any stretch of the means. And so I don't know, I'm thinking about if I should sell that one off, or it's got a lot of different pieces in it from my grandmother and my estate, my mom's estate, from my great auntie, my grandmother, my great grandmother. And I'm not sure. I'm thinking about it still, but it's so beautiful. And the colors are these beautiful teals, greens, and pinks. It's just amazing. But who knows? Anyway, I go through my stuff and I surprise myself and I'm like, wow, that's really cool. But that does not happen without watching your books and what you do with your art and how you express your art through journal making and mixed media as well. So it's pretty fascinating. I'm just always inspired. So anyway, with that said, guys, I guess that's it. Oh, I forgot. I would probably will put in a couple of these really cute little pinks. I forgot about that. Baggies there, because those are very Eastery. I'll put two of those in there. All right. Okay, so I hope everybody is having a beautiful day, night, morning, evening, wherever you are in the world. And I hope you're enjoying the weekend. I probably won't be back on here except for to list, to post a baby's kit, that, I am waiting for the buyer to receive that. And then I will post that. Although she said, it doesn't matter, just post it. So, I'll be back with that. And then, what else do I have? I have a really big fat custom order that have to get out of here by Tuesday. So I'm working on that throughout the weekend, as well as essay grading, which is exciting too. So anyway, guys, I hope everybody's having a great day or night or morning or evening or wherever you are in the world. I'll be back with more goodies. Bye. Adios. Sale pues.